Good morning. So this is a Hyundai Ioniq Electric. It's got the 28 kilowatt hour battery underneath there, and I'm just about to put the under tray back on this car. So I thought I'd do a quick video showing you what's up under there, under the bonnet, and show you the electric powertrain on these. I've probably done one of these videos before. I haven't checked. I'm sure I have actually, but the trouble is with YouTube, once videos are a few years old, they tend to not get many views. So it's probably going to be a similar repeat of that one, but anyway, let's have a look underneath. So looking underneath the car, there's your electric powertrain. If you didn't know much about vehicles, it almost looks like a combustion engine. But anyway, this is your electric motor here. This is your gearbox. There's your drive shafts there driving the front wheels. So the electric motor here, you can see a high voltage cable coming down there into the top of the electric motor. On hybrids and EVs, anything that's orange is the high voltage stuff. So this half is your electric motor. It splits here, and then this half is the reduction gearbox, i.e. the gearbox. And what this is doing is reducing the speed of the motor down to a slow enough speed for your front wheels. And in here is the differential as well. And there we've got the air conditioning compressor, which is bolted onto the side of the electric motor. And then all this lump has got a bracket here with a rubber mounting, sort of an engine mount as it were. There's one there, and then there's one somewhere at the back. Where is it? There. So there's three mounts which mount this whole engine stack, as it were. And then on top of the motor up there, which we'll have a look at the top, is the charger and inverter and all the other electronics. So the other thing that's obvious underneath here is this thing, and this is a three-way valve for the cooling system. So you've got hoses here, which is just sending water from the coolant bottle at the top, and this diverts it through the motor or the motor stack above, you know, your inverter and charger, and then obviously into the bottom of the radiator. This is the lower end of the radiator here. And then above that, up there, which I'm not sure whether you can see that because it's rather dark, that's the water pump. So it's just a plastic water pump, electric water pump, of course, because obviously there's no belt from an engine driving it, and that's just then pumping the coolant around all these hoses, which cools your motor and your electronics up there. So turning around, looking at the front, other stuff we can see here is the radiator, pretty standard radiator with your fan up front and coolant hoses in top and bottom on this side. Here's your windscreen washer bottle sitting down here in the bottom behind your front bumper here. What else can we see underneath? Not much really. There's your daytime running lights there. Your plastic shroud here in the the wheel arch linings. And then you've got your dry shaft here to the front wheels. Your anti-roll bar here with the drop links here. They're usually the first things that go. But yeah, I need to get a bit more light on here. Let me just move this light here. See if we can get a bit more light up in there. Hang on a sec. So yeah, it's a bit difficult to see because we've got the sun coming through the doors and it is rather dark underneath here, and some strong shadows, of course. But anyway, what I'm shining the torch on there is the steering rack, and that white plastic there is the steering column coming down from your steering wheel, of course. And yeah, that's about all we can see underneath here. So let's get the vehicle down and have a look from the top. So here we are looking under the bonnet, and let's start here. So you've got a 12 volt battery. All EVs still have 12 volt batteries, and just like in a combustion engine vehicle, you need that 12 volt battery to start the vehicle. Obviously it's not cranking over an engine because you don't have an engine here, but you need it to unlock the car, turn on the dash. All the ECUs and the dashboard and everything is all 12 volt, just like any other vehicle. And it is still starting the car. Obviously you're not cranking an engine, but when you turn the ignition key, or in this case push the button, stop start button, What it's doing is operating some contactors, which is switching on that high voltage battery under the floor. And from that point on, you've then got your DC power coming into the vehicle and you're running on that traction battery. But the actual starting process, you still need a 12 volt battery. And if that's flat, the vehicle will not start and it also will not charge. So it's completely reliant on a 12 volt, just like a combustion engine vehicle. This is the coolant bottle. And as I said, you've got hoses running down here, going through the radiator. The water pump is just down there. And then you've got the hoses going through your motor at the bottom, and then the charger and inverter circuits up in these huge boxes up here. That's all water cooled, and then it goes back through here through a chiller. So it's pretty standard cooling system, exactly, very similar to what you would have on a combustion engine, but obviously much less cooling is needed because this doesn't get hugely hot like an engine would. Obviously an engine, you've got a fire inside. But yeah, it's just cooling down the electronics, and that's why on EVs you don't need grills, because they have very little cooling needed. So while it's got quite a large radiator here, there's actually very little airflow going through it because it's not needed. So this is that motor stack. So obviously the electric motor sits down at the bottom underneath, but again, if you didn't know much about cars, you would look at this and think that was a combustion engine. And just like a combustion engine, for some reason Hyundai fit plastic covers on the top. So let's pull that off and I'll show you what's under there. So this lot is called the motor stack purely because these aluminium housings all bolt to the top of the motor. So it is still the same size as a combustion engine. But anyway, looking at the top, this first one, top one, which is this slice here, that's called the EPCU, which is the Electronic Power Control Unit. So that's basically your inverter. And you'll see here the orange cables, which are the high voltage cables, are coming into this top box. So you've got your 400 volt DC coming from the traction battery, and that's being converted down to 14 volts DC to charge the 12 volt battery while you're driving or while the car's on. And also being converted down to the power that's needed for the motor, all the other electronics, your air conditioning compressor and all that sort of stuff. And as you can see, this top unit here, your power control unit, is water cooled. So here's the hose coming in, here's the hose coming out, and it's all this coolant here. Right, the next unit down, which is this one here, is the onboard charger, the OBC. And what this is all the electronics needed to charge the car. So when you plug in your charging socket on the back corner of the car, it's all being controlled by this unit here. And again, this is water cooled. You can see this hose here and this hose here. So the hose here out of the onboard charger is coming straight into the radiator on top of the rad there, and the other hose here is going down to probably the water pump there. And then below that you've got the electric motor, and there's that top motor mount there that I was showing you from underneath. All the other stuff here you can see, these hoses, is all the air conditioning. There's a unit under there, so here we can see there's the low pressure connection line in the air conditioning, and there's the high pressure connection point there. And you've got hoses at the back, and then all of this, that's all your air conditioning unit and the heat pump, because all UK Hyundai Ioniqs do have a heat pump. They don't have a resistive heater like some other Ioniqs do in other markets. And then this is your brake fluid reservoir, standard hydraulic brakes, just like any other vehicle. The thing that people often get confused with is that term, regenerative braking. All EVs have regenerative braking, so do hybrids. Regenerative braking is just motor braking. So that electric motor at the bottom, which is driving your front wheels, when you lift off the accelerator and you're not putting electricity into that motor to make it spin, because if your vehicle is moving forward and you've got that kinetic energy going forward, your motor instantly turns into a dynamo. and then that is generating power and it pushes it back into that battery pack, and that's what slows you down. So that's why it's called regenerative braking. It actually doesn't have anything to do with your physical hydraulic brakes. It's just engine braking. And then the final thing under here is this box, and just the same as a combustion engine vehicle, it's a fuse box. And here's all your micro fuses, and then these are all relays, and then on the underside of the lid it tells you what they all are. So as a user, the only thing you're going to open the bonnet for is topping up your windscreen washer bottle here, and probably occasionally jump starting or charging your 12 volt battery here. Just quickly back to the air conditioning, the sticker for that is underneath the bonnet here, and this uses the R1234YF refrigerant. That's supposedly more environmentally friendly, and most EVs use that refrigerant, so do combustion engine vehicles now. And this uses 1.1 kilograms of refrigerant, 1,100 grams plus or minus 25 grams. That's an awful lot. That's about twice the capacity of the average vehicle. And it's vital that you keep that up to its optimum capacity of 1.1 kilos. So the reality is all vehicles do slowly leak refrigerant. And on average, vehicles leak about 50 grams a year. And you should really have your car regassed about every 3 to 4 years. And when a garage does that, they connect into the high and low points here, and the machine sucks all the refrigerant out, measures it, weighs it, and then pumps all of your refrigerant back in and tops it up to get to that 1.1 kilograms. There's also oil in the system as well. So it does suck out a little bit of oil again, it puts the oil back in, and that lubricates the system. So it is vital that your air conditioning is kept to that level, particularly if you've got an air pump. It's really vital on Veno Zoes, because you lose your heating if that refrigerant gets low. But yeah, every 3 to 4 years you do want to have that checked, and it's not something you need to go to Hyundai for. You can have mobile services come out and do it. There's people in vans that do air conditioning regasses, or your local garage will probably be able to do it. The key thing is ask them whether they've got the R1234YF refrigerant. Final thing, the 12 volt battery on these is a 40 amp hour 354 cold cranking amp spec. These are typical Asian, very tall and pretty small batteries, but obviously with an EV it's not really doing too much work. And the tray that it sits in, you couldn't fit anything any bigger, so it would have to be exactly the same capacity battery going in. There is actually an advantage with a lot of EVs to fit bigger capacity batteries, because a lot of modern cars, it's not just a problem on EVs, it's all modern cars, they tend to have a habit of draining the 12 volt batteries when they're sat still, just because cars are full of a lot more electronics now with all this telematics, and you've got apps. And obviously to use an app, the car has got to wake up, and it's all being driven by the 12 volt battery. So 12 volt batteries tend to be a much bigger issue going flat in modern vehicles than they were on your previous sort of ICE vehicle and older vehicles. But in this case, because of the way that tray is, you couldn't fit any other battery in here apart from obviously the same spec. So I'm back underneath the vehicle, of course, and what a lot of people are going to want to see is the battery, but there really isn't much to see under here, because you've got this trays underneath going the full length of the vehicle. So it's all nice and flat, so it's very aerodynamic and efficient. I'm not going to take these trays off because there really isn't anything to see underneath. The battery sits in a metal box, usually aluminium, and it's just one big box with an orange cable coming out one end going to the front. So there's really not much to see under there, but obviously with EVs the batteries are always under the floor, nice down low, so all the weight is low, center gravity is low, and that's what EVs handle so well. On these Ioniq 38s the battery is air cooled, so underneath your back seat, which will be somewhere here, is a fan, and when it's needed it will force cool air around the battery pack. The newer 38 kilowatt cars do have a water cooled battery. Not that that's really any better. The cooling on these cars is absolutely brilliant. Forced air cooling does the job. And actually, we're starting to see some Ioniq 38s with poorer battery degradation than these 28s. These 28s are absolutely bulletproof. So forced air cooling is up to the job, but obviously they decided to add water cooling to the newer one. Probably it's because they're forcing more battery cells into the same size box. So maybe that will generate a bit more heat, of course. So they introduce water cooling on the new ones. They do have a bit of trouble actually on the new ones with the coolant on those. And they are going to start changing the coolant to a different type. But anyway, 28s, forced air cooling, does the job. These are absolutely bulletproof. They've got incredible battery life on these cars, which I've covered in other videos. So I think that's about all I can do on this video. So if you've enjoyed it and liked it, please do click that thumbs up video on YouTube. That really does help. Do subscribe if you haven't. There's hundreds of EV videos on the channel already, and I'll see you on the next video.